Hello students, yesterday we have started this unit, that is bacterial cultivation and maintenance, and in that we have seen some basic concepts regarding culturing of bacteria, and then we have started about the classification of culture media, in which that culture media can be classified at three different levels. That is on the basis of their consistency, nutritional component and functional use. So according to the consistency, that nutrient media are of three different types, such as liquid media, solid media and semi-solid media. And then on the basis of nutritional components, again that media are of three different types, such as simple media, complex media and synthetic or chemically defined media. Now today in this lecture we will see about the classification of nutritional media on the basis of functional use or its application. So according to this criteria, that culture media or nutrient media is classified into six different types. And that includes number 1 enriched media, number 2 selective media, number 3 differential media, number 4 transport media, number 5 indicator media, and number 6 anaerobic media. So one by one we are going to see all these different types of media. Before that, if you have not subscribed this Microbiology by Santosh Napte, so kindly subscribe this channel and share these videos with your friends. So let's start classification of culture media on the basis of functional use or application. So the first we will see here, that is enriched media. So what are these enriched media? So addition of extra nutrients that may be in the form of blood, serum, egg yolk to a basal nutrient medium makes that particular media as an enriched media. So basal nutrient medium, it is simply nothing but the consisting of some basic components or some required components for the growth of bacteria. But when you are adding some additional nutrients to this basal nutrient medium, and that additional nutrients may be in the form of blood, serum, egg yolk, so that media we can call as an enriched media. And these enriched media, later on these are used to isolate a particular pathogen from a mixed culture. So these enriched media, these are very useful for the isolation of pathogenic microorganisms from a specimen. And these media, they stimulate growth of a desired bacterium in which you are interested. And simultaneously, the components present in this enriched media, they inhibit the growth of unwanted bacterium. It means this enriched media, it allows the growth of only desired bacterium, but it inhibit the growth of unwanted bacterium. And the media, it is incorporated with some inhibitory substances. So these inhibitory substances, they suppress or they inhibit the growth of unwanted organisms, and therefore they increase the numbers of a desired bacteria. So when there is an inhibition or suppression of the growth of unwanted organisms, automatically that enriched media promote the number or increasing numbers of the desired bacteria. Examples of these enriched media includes chocolate agar, blood agar, then selenite F broth, which is specifically useful for the isolation of Salmonella and Shigella, then tetrathionate broth, which inhibits the coliforms, and alkaline peptone water, which is useful for the isolation of Vibrio cholerae. So these are the examples of enriched media. See, these are the diagram or tubes showing the enriched media here. This is selenite F broth, this is tetrathionate broth, and this is alkaline peptone water. So these are the broth. It means these media are liquid media. because these are broth, it does not consist of agar agar. So that's why they are liquid in nature. So chocolate agar, it is a non-selective enriched growth medium, and it is useful for the growing of fastidious bacteria. Fastidious bacteria means here such type of bacteria, they require a specific nutrients, and these are provided by this chocolate agar. So the example of that bacterium which can be cultivated or which can be cultured by using this medium, that is chocolate agar, the name of that bacteria is Haemophilus influenzae. Then second type of example of this medium is blood agar. So these blood agar plates, which consist of mammalian blood, which is usually taken from the sheep or horse, and typically at a concentration of 5 to 10%. So if you want to prepare 100 ml blood agar, then you have to add 5 to 10% of sheep or horse blood in the nutrient medium. So this blood agar plates or this blood agar, this is enriched differential media. It is used to isolate fastidious organisms, and at the same time these are used to detect the hemolytic activity of the bacteria. So this is about the enriched medium examples. So this is the blood agar and this is chocolate agar. Next one is here selective medium. So as the name suggests here, these media are selective media that allow the growth of only selected microorganisms. So the inhibitory substances which are added to this solid media, they can cause an increase in the number of colonies of a desired bacterium. But these inhibitory substances, they does not allow the growth of unwanted bacteria. So these selective media and enriched media, these are designed or these are prepared to inhibit the unwanted commensal bacteria or microorganisms, or these are designed to inhibit the growth of contaminating bacteria. So these unwanted commensal or that contaminated bacteria, these are not, or they will not grow in this selective media, because this selective media has inhibitory substances that prevent the growth of these contaminating bacteria. And that's why this selective media, they help to recover pathogens from a specimen or from a mixed culture of bacteria. So it allows the growth of only desired microorganisms or only selective microorganisms. That's why this media is called as selective media. So any other media that can be made selectively, or that can be made selective just by addition of a particular inhibitory substances, that does not affect the pathogen, or it allows the growth of that pathogen, but it is inhibitory to unwanted microorganisms. And to make a medium selective that includes addition of inhibitory substances such as antibiotics, dyes, chemicals, or alteration of pH of a nutrient medium, or combination of all of these. So by doing such actions, that is by addition of inhibitory substances or by changing the pH of that nutrient medium, we can make that media as a selective media. So examples of selective media includes thiamidine medium, which is selective for Neisseria gonorrhoeae. So this bacterium Neisseria gonorrhoeae, it is a causative agent of a sexually transmitted disease, that is gonorrhea. Then EMB agar, or which is called as eosin methylene blue agar, it is selective for gram negative bacteria. That means it allows the growth of gram negative bacteria, and the dye, that is methylene blue, present in this medium, it inhibits the growth of gram positive bacteria. So presence of this methylene blue in this eosin methylene blue agar, it does not allow the growth of gram positive bacteria. It allows the growth of only gram-negative bacteria. It means if you want to grow gram-negative bacteria, and if you want to prevent the growth of gram-positive bacteria, then you can use this EMB agar. Then small amounts of this dye, it effectively inhibits the growth of many gram-positive bacteria. Next example of selective media is Campylobacter agar. So this Campylobacter agar, it is used for the selective isolation of Campylobacter jejuni. See, this is the diagram of eosin methylene blue agar and this is campylobacter agar. Next type of media is differential media. So differential media, it means such type of media, they can differentiate that organisms into different types. So that's why this media is called as differential media. And these are designed in such a way that different bacteria can be recognized or can be identified on the basis of their colony color. Just by observing the color of that particular colonies, you can differentiate that bacteria into different types. So these media differentiate that bacteria by observing the color. That's why these medias are called as differential media. And various approaches in this differential media includes incorporation or addition of dyes, then metabolic substrates, so that those bacteria that utilize them or that utilize these substances added to that medium, they appear differently colored colonies. And substances which are incorporated in this medium, they are enable it to distinguish between the bacteria. Examples of differential media includes Macconkey's agar. So these Macconkey's agar, these are useful for the isolation of coliform bacteria. And by using this Macconkey's agar, we can differentiate between lactose fermenting bacteria and lactose non-fermenting bacteria. Because when that particular sample consists of coliform bacteria and when you will grow this coliform bacteria on this Macconkey's agar, then these bacteria, they will produce pink color colonies. And if that, because they ferment the lactose and produces acid, so that's why that colonies appear pink. If there is a presence of non-coliform bacteria and if you are growing these non-coliform bacteria on Macconkey's agar, then actually these non-coliform bacteria, they does not ferment that lactose sugar present in this medium, and therefore there is no acid production. That's why the colonies of non-coliform bacteria, they appear colorless. So just by observing the color, if you can differentiate that bacteria into coliform or non-coliform. So that's why this Macconkey's agar, it is a differential nutrient medium. Then another differential media is CLED agar and XLD agar. The next one, xylose lysine deoxycholate agar. So this XLD or xylose lysine deoxycholate agar, it is used as a selective as well as differential medium for the growing of or cultivation of Salmonella as well as Shigella species. Then another one media is cysteine lactose electrolyte deficient agar, or which is called as CLED agar. It is a non-selective solid medium for the cultivation of pathogens from the urine samples or urine specimens. And absence of salts or electrolytes that inhibits the swarming of Proteus species. Then, as I told earlier here, Macconkey's agar culture medium, it is specifically designed to grow gram-negative bacteria, that is coliforms, and it differentiates for them for lactose fermentation. So this Macconkey's agar, it consists of bile salt, which is inhibitory to the most gram-positive bacteria. Then it also consists of crystal violet dye, which is also inhibitory to the gram-positive bacteria, and there is a presence of lactose sugar. So these lactose fermenters, they produce pink colonies on, and non-lactose fermenters, they produce colorless colonies. So by using this Macconkey's agar, you can differentiate between lactose fermenters and non-lactose fermenters. So if there is a presence of lactose fermenters, they will produce pink color colonies. If there is a presence of non-lactose fermenters, they will produce colorless colonies. See, this is the diagram of Macconkey's agar and this is CLED agar. And this is the growth of pathogenic E. coli or Escherichia coli on CLED agar. Then fourth type of nutrient media is transport media. As the name suggests here, these media are used to transport that specimen from the site of collection to the laboratory. So these clinical specimens, they must be transported to the laboratory immediately after the collection to prevent the overgrowth of contaminating organisms or the commensals. So in many cases what happens that sample is collected at one site and it should be taken to the laboratory for further investigation. So in such cases there should be requirement or there is a requirement of a special nutrient medium, and that special nutrient medium it is called as transport medium, that is to transport the clinical specimens. So these delicate organisms, they may not survive in time taken for transporting the specimen without a transport media. If you are not using any transport media and if you are transporting that specimen from the site of collection to the laboratory, then that microorganisms can be died. So that's why to keep alive that organisms present in the specimens, there is a need of this transport media, and that can be achieved by using this transport media. So this transport media, it should fulfill the following criteria. Number one, temporary storage of specimens being transported to the laboratory for cultivation. Number two, that transport media maintain the viability of all organisms in the specimen without changing their concentration. Then it consists of only buffers and salt. Then there should be lack of carbon, the nitrogen and organic growth factors so as to prevent the microbial multiplication. And next one is here, that is transport media used in the isolation of anaerobic organisms must be free of molecular oxygen. So these are the some criteria for the selection of a transport media. So examples of transport media includes Carey Blair medium for a bacterium Campylobacter, then alkaline peptone water medium for Vibrio cholerae, then Stott's medium, that is a non-nutrient soft agar gel containing a reducing agent and charcoal, which is useful for gonococci, and buffered glycerol saline for the transportation of enteric bacilli. So these are the examples of transport media. See, these are the transport media or tubes containing transport media. Next one is indicator media. So such types of media, they contains an indicator which changes its color when a particular bacteria grows in this media. So when there is a growth of specific bacteria in such media, so there is a change in the color. So occurrence of change in the color of this media, it indicates the growing of that particular bacteria. So that's why this is called as indicator media. Examples include Wilson Blair medium, that is for Salmonella typhi, which forms the black colonies. Then Macleod's medium, that is potassium tellurite, specifically for diphtheria bacilli. Then urea's media, that urea, in which that urea get converted to carbon dioxide and ammonia, and that ammonia that which turns that medium pink. So these are the these changes in color, it indicates the growth of bacteria. So that's why these media are called as indicator media. So this is Wilson Blair medium and this is Macleod's medium, and this is about the urease medium. So there is a change in the color, so that's indicate growth of microorganisms. So this is the before incubation tube and this is after incubation. So change in color, it indicates the growth of that bacteria, so that's why it is a indicator medium. And sixth type of media, that is according to the functional use or according to the application, and that is called as anaerobic media. So these anaerobic bacteria, they need a special media for growth because they need low oxygen content, reduced oxidation reduction potential, and they also require extra nutrients. So for the cultivation of such anaerobic bacteria, there is a need of anaerobic media, and that media for these anaerobes, they may have to be supplemented with nutrients like hemin or vitamin K. So boiling the medium, it serves to expel any dissolved oxygen. And examples of anaerobic media includes thioglycolate medium. So this thioglycolate medium, it is the example of anaerobic media. So this is the thioglycolate medium here. So here we have finished about the different types of cultivation or culture media on the basis of three different criteria, that is consistency, then later on solid or liquid media, and then according to the functional use or according to the application. So kindly subscribe this Microbiology by Santosh Napte and share this video with your friends. In tomorrow's lecture, we will see about the different culture methods. That is, how that bacteria can be cultivated in laboratory by using different techniques. So there are different techniques are there for the culturing of microorganisms, and basically that includes strict plate technique or method, pore plate method, and spread plate method. So all these culture methods we will see in tomorrow's lecture. Thank you.